Hello, this is Denise Yohn, and welcome to a preview of Beyond Marketing, Operationalize Your Brand to Grow Your Business. This program is probably more appropriately named to Marketing and Beyond, because when it comes to brand building, I think we marketers have a lot to learn from the Buzz Lightyear character in the Toy Story movies. He's futuristic, optimistic, and always exhorting the gang of toys to reach for new heights and explore the bigger universe out there. But so often, we run around like Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head, worrying and frantic, seeing brand building through a very narrow lens, like we're missing an eye. We focus on ad campaigns and the size of our marketing budgets, when the reality is those levers rarely correlate directly with results. Gap serves as a case in point. Over the course of 2 years, the company ran big budget ad campaigns. For example, the Red campaign, spending $58 million on that one. But it didn't sustain any sales growth. We also know the reverse is true. Zappos has built a strong, valuable brand despite little or no spending on advertising and marketing. So have Google, Facebook, and Starbucks until recent years. When you look at these data points, it becomes clear that promoting your brand doesn't necessarily build it. Brand power must be created by something beyond advertising and marketing. So what drives brand strength? Well, my colleagues and I conducted some research to discern what drives brand power. What do organizations do to build their brands? We asked CMOs and marketing directors to select which of these levers drive successful brand execution. Can you guess which of these were rated as critically important? Pretty much all of them. Here are the average scores. Notice how they're all right around 4. This means that most marketing executives think everything is important. Problem is, with limited resources and limited budgets, you can't do everything. Doing everything is not the answer. Doing different things is. Instead of thinking about brand building as an externally oriented activity, we need to shift to more internally directed efforts. That is, instead of telling people who we are and what we do, let's focus on who we actually are and what we actually do. Your brand has a unique ability to explain what your company is all about and to galvanize your organization to deliver on that promise. So it can have immense, direct, and lasting impact on all areas of your business, not only marketing. But in order to have this impact, your organization must stop only using your brand as an outward-facing, image-oriented message. It's the core of your business, and as such, it can be used as a tool for managing it. So for the rest of this session, I want you to take off your marketing hats and think more broadly about your business and how you can drive it with your brand from the inside out. The way to do this is what I call brand as business. Brand as business is a management approach which involves the deliberate and systematic management of the business around the brand. It's a management strategy that's more in tune with the changing market and that enables companies to optimize their core operating system in meeting new demand. It involves using your brand as a management tool, not simply a marketing asset. The rest of this program explains what the brand as business management approach is all about. It gives details on what brand as business entails, compares it to other brand building approaches, and shows how companies in different sectors can use it. I introduce some of the specific tools it draws upon and share examples of companies that have used these tools to fuel their success. Ultimately, brand as business transforms brand building from a costly, discrete, and subjective activity into the most integral way of managing and growing your business. It's the new management approach that will take your brand to infinity and beyond. Please contact me to learn more or to arrange to share this program with your organization.